Welcome back. So tomorrow, another chilly day. Might need a sweater.
Yeah, might need your sweater tomorrow, but mostly sunny as we head into the next 24 hours. Here's a look at your weather headlines as we go into tomorrow. We can expect those breezy conditions to start to lighten up as we head into tomorrow morning, but it's going to be clear and cold tonight. Temperatures in the low 30s, and then tomorrow, sunny and chilly with highs only getting up into the 60s. But we do have some rain chances returning back to the Conchoval Valley for Thursday afternoon into Friday. Good news that these rain chances are diminishing as we get closer towards that day, but we could still see some scattered to isolated showers all across the area for the next few days here. Wednesday, sunny. Thursday and Friday, Thursday night, expect to see those 20% chance of isolated showers possible. And that's all due to a strong cold front that's going to be moving through the area. And that's going to cause us to be very cold for Thursday. Highs only getting up into the 40s and then warming up. And then our next weather system coming through next Monday that will bring us some slight rain chances, mainly for our southeastern counties as we go into the next several hours there. But looking at our time lapse, we did have overcast skies, a very gloomy day today, but that sun did make its appearance in the evening hours, and now we're dealing with clear conditions and dry conditions because we are going to expect to see those temperatures fall into the 30s as we go into those overnight hours. But looking at for the past, looking at actually right now, we are seeing those temperatures at 42 right now. Clear skies, winds out of the west at 7 miles an hour. Good news here is that we're not dealing with that wind that we saw earlier today. Right now across the Concho Valley in the low 40s in the northern areas, 39 in Mertzon, 42 in El Dorado. We're going to continue to see those temperatures tumble into about 32. We could hit the freezing mark tonight for us here in the Concho Valley, of course, for us here in San Angelo. Looking at those wind speeds, we are seeing those winds out of the west at 7 miles an hour. A little bit more breezy in Sterling City, out of the north at 10 miles an hour there. So all that, those breezy conditions have definitely moved off towards the east, so they're still dealing with somewhat breezy conditions in and around the Brady area, just in eastern McCulloch County there. Looking at that wind tracker, as we head into those overnight hours, we could still occasionally see those wind gusts up to about 20, 25 miles an hour as we head into tomorrow morning there. So expect to see some breezy conditions lasting tonight for the good portion of tonight, and then tomorrow a little bit more calmer in terms of those wind speeds going into the next several days. Looking across the West Texas here, we are seeing this that upper level low pressure system moving across the Texas-Oklahoma state line. You're able to see that distinct spin there with all those showers and thunderstorms off to our east as we look at that system making its way closer towards Arkansas and Louisiana, clearing skies out for us here across West Texas there. And of course that cold front well to the south of us, clearing those skies. It's actually moving through the Houston area right now. But looking at the water vapor imagery, we are seeing that spin, seeing a lot of dry air behind that. But as far as our extended future cast is concerned, we are expecting just a clear sun Wednesday, but then that cloud cover returning for Thursday. Could see a few spotty showers for Thursday morning, and then Thursday afternoon may see some scattered isolated showers lasting into the early morning hours for Friday. But of course, with a lot cooler conditions as that big system moves through the area just in time for the first day of rodeo season. So definitely take your jackets if you are going outside on Thursday, because you could deal with some wet conditions and some cold conditions with highs only remaining in the 40s. Return of cloud cover is expected for next Sunday and Monday. Those temperatures are going to be gradually warming up into the 70s. We could surpass 75 degrees going into Sunday and Monday, but then our next weather system, our next cold front will move through Monday afternoon, causing some showers for our southeastern areas there as we head into the start of next week, and then cooler conditions expected for next Tuesday as we head into the second day of next week there. Looking at that extended future cast across the state of Texas, mainly sunny for 60 degrees. So if you're traveling across the state, we're going to see that increasing rain for Thursday as that system moves through the area. Highs only getting up into the upper 40s for us here in San Angelo. We're going to be going up to about 60 degrees. We're going to be quickly warming up as we head into the next several days after that big cold front on Thursday. Tonight getting down to 32 degrees, mostly clear and breezy with winds out of the northwest at 15 to 20 miles an hour, at times gusting to 25 miles an hour. Tomorrow topping out at 57 degrees, sunny but still chilly as we head into the next several days. But looking at your official rodeo, first day of rodeo forecast, we can expect 20% chance of isolated showers, highs only getting up to 45 for us here in San Angelo as we head into the next 7 days. But looking at for our 7 day forecast, expect to see those temperatures once again in the 60s. Rodeo parade could look a little bit clear, but a little bit chilly as we head into Saturday morning with highs topping out at around 68 degrees. So definitely bring your jackets if you're traveling in the early morning hours. Of course, those overnight with chilly conditions, highs eventually back into the 70s. I don't know about you, Lisette, but I'm waiting for that 70 degree weather to come back into the picture, because today was a little bit miserable.
I know, we were mad that it wasn't feeling like winter. Now it's feeling like winter. Now we're
we can't be happy, you know.
We can't be happy. All right, thanks, Chris. How one Texas bus